Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of the Ball Fake Podcast. If you're watching on YouTube, make sure to like, subscribe, and support our new movement by putting Let's Go Viral in the comment section. But if you're listening on Apple Podcasts or Spotify, make sure to give us a 5-star rating and a nice review. But without further ado, here are your hosts, Nicely Chunga Benny and Greg King.
What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of the Ball Fake Podcast. Today, we're going to talk about some Ben Simmons trade scenarios, and we're going to touch bases just shortly on why we think Ben Simmons struggled this postseason. And with that being said, I want to start off with this Atlanta Hawks series. Obviously, Ben Simmons, he vastly underperformed, averaged a little bit under 10 points per game versus Atlanta, and he took zero field goal attempts in the fourth quarter in five games of a seven-game series. Not to mention that he shot 34% from the free throw line, and which is the worst in NBA history in a postseason. So obviously, we already know Ben Simmons has definitely been one of the biggest problems on his team. But one reason why I think Ben Simmons did struggle to a certain degree, not only in this postseason, but for the better half of this year, is I think he was, I don't want to say he was misutilized, because I think Doc Rivers did a decent job of, you know, coaching him. But I think the fact that he had less of an opportunity to play point guard this year really kind of hurt his game and his confidence. Because when you take the ball out of a guy's hands who is best at being able to create shots for others and being able to initiate the offense, and he's been doing that for 3 of the 4 years that he's been in Philadelphia, I think that hurt his confidence to a certain degree. Doc Rivers made an effort to make him a minimized, having a minimized role on his team. He turned him into somebody who sets a lot of screens off ball, and then just having to play that way. And then not to mention the fit with Joel Embiid is already not going to be in favor of Ben Simmons games, because it's going to force him to shoot a lot of jumpers. So I just feel like all that kind of played a part in as to why he underperformed this postseason. And then obviously we already know not only does he not have a jump shot, but he's also a terrible free throw shooter. And you know, we got to give credit to the Atlanta Hawks for making that adjustment, sending him to the free throw line, and then making him beat them off that, obviously. And then they also took away transition opportunities for Ben Simmons. We all know this is where he gets the majority of his points, out in the open break. And the fact that they took Doc Rivers didn't allow him to really play much of a point guard role, and Atlanta took away transition opportunities, I think that is one of the, those are some of the biggest reasons as to why he underperformed this postseason and the entire year.
Yeah, I totally agree. Atlanta did a great job just not making Ben Simmons comfortable and just really affecting them. We have to give them credit, really affecting them on the offensive end. But I have to, your point was right. The system, I think, definitely played a role in this. But I also have to call out Ben Simmons. You're an NBA player. You got to be able to work on your game. You have to have a sense of urgency to work on your game in the offseason. Work on the things that you need to get better at. And I think even with the shooting thing, if you don't want to work on the three-point shot, okay, then at least start with a floater. Then come out to 10 feet. Come out to 12 feet. Then work on your free throw. Take it baby steps. You don't have to go from not shooting to three-point shooting. We just take it baby steps so you can at least be effective in the half-court set, because when it comes to the playoffs, you have to be able to run sets in the half-court set to be effective, because there's less transition, like you said. So being able to be effective in the half-court set and help your teammates on the offensive end is the reason why I think hindered Simmons the most. He's not doing any work in the offseason to get better.
Well, I actually disagree. I've seen clips of him, you know, working on his game as far as that jump shot and everything, but I don't think he's mature enough to, you know, have it translate to his to an actual NBA game just yet. I don't know. That's more so, like we said, it's probably a psychological thing.
It's definitely a mental thing. Mental is the biggest side of sports in general. So I think that whoever he needs to either get refocused, lock in, and really, really get with somebody that's going to hone in on those skills.
Right. And, you know, with all that being said, this is what's led us to all these trade rumors and scenarios. Yeah. And the first one we're going to talk about is the Trailblazers trading CJ McCollum to the Philadelphia 76ers. Now, the Sixers, they would get somebody who has shot creation ability on the perimeter and somebody who's able to, you know, get baskets one on one. And not to mention, this is a guy that shoots nearly 40% from three. And that's an area where the Philadelphia 76ers need to improve. And on top of that, they would also be able to play an inside-out game, having CJ McCollum on the perimeter play through Joel Embiid in the interior. I think this was a nightmare for a ton of opposing defenses. And ultimately, this looks like it could be a roster that's good enough with McCollum to be able to get over that hump and make it to the NBA Finals. And then when it comes to what Portland's getting in Ben Simmons, obviously we already know about what he's able to do on the defensive side of the basketball, but he's also an additional playmaker. Not saying that Damian Lillard can't playmake, but I do think that Ben Simmons would be a lot would allow him to play off ball a little bit more and then ultimately just be able to run a more fluid offense with him. The only question is, how does he fit with Jusuf Nurkić? There has been some rumors about Nurkić possibly wanting out, but we'll just have to wait and see for next season and everything.
Yeah, I like this fit too, and especially for the Portland Trailblazers because they were 29th in defensive rating during the NBA season. And I think that bringing in a guy like Ben Simmons who can help on the perimeter and help them out in those closing games, in those close tight games where they need to get a stop, I think that'll help them tremendously on that side of the basketball. And then on the offensive end for them, I think with Damian Lillard not being really a playmaker, I think having a secondary playmaker on the perimeter like a Ben Simmons who can set up teammates and put guys in position but also space out the floor where Ben Simmons can be effective, I think that's a great role for Ben Simmons. And as far as the 76ers and what CJ McCollum bring, like you said, I think it's huge because what Philly lacked this playoffs was another perimeter guard on the wing who has shot creation ability, who could knock down a shot when they needed it. So I think CJ McCollum can come in and bring that intensity on that side of the basketball.
Yeah, especially alongside with a guy like Tobias Harris, because I think Tobias Harris is the one that they were betting on for that perimeter production. And obviously, he just hasn't really been enough for them to be able to advance and get to the NBA Finals ultimately.
Yeah.
But our next trade package is including Andrew Wiggins and a first round pick. And then obviously, the Warriors would be able to get Ben Simmons. But Greg, what are your thoughts on this trade?
I like it for the Warriors. I do not like it for Wiggins. Yes, Wiggins improved in that system and got better and got more comfortable, but I think putting the keys to Wiggins to your organization, I just don't think that would work out with a guy who's kind of streaky and kind of inconsistent from shooting wise, and then he kind of operates from the high post and stuff like that, and kind of like a slasher. We kind of see like a mimic of kind of like an Embiid and Ben Simmons that we've already seen. So I don't see how that would work. But for the Warriors, I think it's amazing. You bring in a Ben Simmons who can play make, and you have those shooters around him. You got him and Draymond Green. They would be tremendous on the defensive end and guarding that perimeter, and I think it would be really effective and really give Clay and Steph more opportunities on the perimeter to knock down shots.
Yeah, if you're Philadelphia, you're definitely denying this trade 100%. Wiggins, he's not going to help you from any aspect of this game, in all honesty. If anything, you probably digress. He's not the offensive player that you really need, and defensively, he definitely doesn't make up for what you lost in Ben Simmons. So
exactly.
If you're Philadelphia, this trade is definitely a no-go. But if you're the Golden State Warriors, I really like this trade. I mean, adding Ben Simmons adds a lot of size to your starting lineup. Not only does he do that, but he also would be able to balance the playmaking and be able to, you know, really take advantage of that shooting on the perimeter that Golden State has. And then not to mention, this is a lineup that would be almost perfect on the defensive end of the basketball, having Ben Simmons possibly play the five, Draymond Green at the four, Klay Thompson running the two guard, and then, you know, whomever else is out there on the court. It's going to be a very big nightmare for the opposing offenses that are going to have to go up against this unit. And then on top of that, you can take either one of these guys out of the lineup and you're still going to be able to have a lot of defensive anchors on the court and playmakers at all times. So I really like this trade package if I'm Golden State. But according to the Chicago Bulls, they will be trading Zach LaVine and Alfred Aminu for Ben Simmons and Matisse Thybulle and Tyrese Maxey. Greg, what are your thoughts on this trade package?
I like this trade because I think the Chicago Bulls need another. I think they need adding a guy like Ben Simmons will definitely boost your defense on the defensive side where you struggled, and on the perimeter. And I think that bringing a guy like Ben Simmons who can help like a Kobe White and these other young guys on the team, and having Vucevic too, they can play that pick and pop, pick and roll. And I think Vucevic can play very well off of Ben Simmons. And I think Ben Simmons ability to play make from the perimeter and a guy who has good handle and can get to the rim and set up other guys on the team, I think this would be a really huge addition for the Chicago Bulls. Now for Zach LaVine and the 76ers, this would be huge. You bring in a guy who's a up and coming rising star, a guy who just made the All-Star team this year, who could just score the basketball. He improved his stats in all areas. He's a great three-level scorer, and I think he would pair really well with Ben with Joel Embiid and would be super, super effective for the 76ers.
Do you think they would make it to the NBA Finals adding Zach LaVine?
I do. It would be tough. It would be very, very tough. We would have to see it, because would they lose a guy like Matisse Thybulle or Tyrese Maxey in that deal?
Yeah, they would lose Thibault and Tyrese Maxey, actually. Yeah, but so, I think you have to take into account what the Brooklyn Nets look like, what Boston brings in.
Yeah, that's what I was about
in,
to say. Yeah,
and, exactly, you know, these other top teams in the Eastern Conference.
Exactly, but if we're just talking about Thibault and Tyrese Maxey, you lose a guy, you lose a young star like Thibault who can defend on the defensive side and was very good, very X-factor. He made the all-defensive second team, so you would lose another type of Ben Simmons type of player who helps you on the perimeter on defense. And then for Tyrese Maxey, you lost a guy off the bench who could come in and score in bunches. So I don't know if they make the NBA finals, but they would push to Eastern Conference finals finally if they had Zach LaVine.
Yeah, I definitely agree from that standpoint. And obviously talking about the Chicago Bulls, getting a guy like Ben Simmons and matching him up with Nikola Vucevic, oh my God, it'd be a nightmare for any front court. I mean, these two offensively, they would be phenomenal. They'd be able to play off of each other, interchange them from the mid post to the low post. You could put Simmons in either area. Same thing with Nikola Vucevic. And then, obviously, you know, like you stated, Matisse Thybulle, he brings a lot of defense and a lot of wing defense on that perimeter. So that's an area where the Bulls definitely need to get help from as well. And then obviously Tyrese Maxey, he's just the bonus with, you know, the production off the bench. You know, he's the second coming of Lou Williams in some people's eyes. And offensively, he was good enough to, you know, not have the Philadelphia 76ers throw him in a trade package for James Harden. So that really let you know a lot about how everyone feels about this kid's game. But as far as LaVine and Embiid as a 1-2 punch, oh my God, it would be a nightmare. I mean, this is guaranteed offense. And then what Al-Farouq Aminu brings to the table, I mean, you know, his athleticism and his length, he's able to, you know, contribute from that aspect of the game on the offensive and defensive side of the basketball. And that's not to mention his three-point capability and the fact that he's a great rebounder who can also defend. And then on top of that, I think the best thing about this guy is not only his athleticism, but the fact that he's able to get a lot out of these driving, kick, and driving abilities. So I really like this trade for both sides. But the last trade we're going to talk about is the Minnesota Timberwolves trading D'Angelo Russell for Ben Simmons. Greg, what are your thoughts on this one?
I like this trade, in my opinion, for the Minnesota Timberwolves, because I think that, first of all, they were 28th in defensive rating. And then I think you bring in a guy like Ben Simmons, who's friends with Carl Anthony Towns. I think that chemistry will show on the court. And I think that you can do pick and pops. You can space the floor. And with Carl Anthony Towns' shooting ability and mid-range ability and ability to knock down three-point shots, I think that will open up the floor for the Minnesota Timberwolves. And it'll create more opportunities for a guy like Anthony Edwards to be more efficient, Malik Beasley and their other shooters. And then on defense, Malik Beasley and Ben Simmons will be a terror on the perimeter on defense and really lock down and help them on the defensive side and get stops. Now, as far as the Minnesota Timberwolves, you bring in D'Angelo Russell, who's a kind of like a combo guard. He can shoot, and I think him and Embiid will play decent together. I think he can set up the offense and be a good perimeter scorer that the 76ers desperately need.
Yeah, and I mean, just to add on to that, like you said, combination guard, somebody who can create a shot for not only himself, but others around him. And then I think he takes a lot of pressure off of Joel Embiid from an offensive standpoint, even late down the stretch in certain games, because we know D'Angelo Russell, he's knocked down a ton of big shots throughout his NBA career. But I think the question is he enough to really propel this team not only to the NBA Finals, but past their Eastern Conference Finals? So, I mean, that's a big question mark right there. I don't know how I feel about that. But as far as the Timberwolves, yes, getting Ben Simmons, oh my God, it's going to do a lot for this unit. I mean, I really like the age timeline within this group. I mean, you got a lot of 24, 23-year-olds mixed in with, you know, a few 21, 22-year-olds. So it's a healthy balance. You know, a lot of these guys are going to be able to grow all at the same time and really be able to develop around each other. And then Carl Anthony Towns and Anthony Edwards, they're not going to hurt the spacing on this floor because they stretch it out for you. They play on the perimeter. And that's going to allow a guy like Ben Simmons to really be able to attack the lanes and do whatever he wants from an offensive standpoint. So this trade, it's definitely a A-plus for me if I'm the Minnesota Timberwolves. But if I'm the Philadelphia 76ers, I'd probably give it a B-, just because D'Angelo Russell, he's not like a James Harden kind of caliber player. But yeah, let us know what you guys think in the comment section. Thank you for tuning in to another episode of the Ball Fake Podcast. We greatly appreciate it. If you're new to our YouTube channel, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and turn on post notification. And if you're listening on Apple Podcasts or Spotify, make sure to give us a 5-star rating and a nice review. But besides that, it's your boy, Nicey Chunga Benny. I'm here with my co-host, Greg King, and we out.
We out.